So here's that Gateway TA1 that I talked about in an earlier video, also known as the CX2620 model. Today we're going to see if a T5200 CPU can fit in there. It is a dual core, and the reason why it gives me hope is because it's the same front side bus as the CPU it takes. It's not a 667 like the T2500 I tried before. It's a 533, and I've seen some posts that have this model with a dual core CPU. So putting those two things together, I think it's worth a shot. Okay, so a lot of gateway models, specifically the MA line, the MT line, and this, the TA line, are really easy to work with because there's a single back panel that you can remove, and this will cover replacing the RAM, replacing the CPU. Not like some other manufacturers where you have to go from the back and then go to the front and then take up the bezel for the power plate and then take up the keyboard. And no, this is a really nice configuration here, as you can see. Got the RAM over there, got the CPU assembly over here. It is a larger assembly, but we've done this before, and so we're going to do it again. Okay, and we're just going to sort of slide this back and flip it over for easy access. You have the CPU and the GPU, which we'll put a little bit more thermal paste on. There's a thermal pad there, but a little extra paste doesn't hurt. There's the CPU, and this is what we're going to see if we can upgrade. Okay, so I didn't put the backplate on because, of course, I think there might be a problem, and yes, it doesn't like the CPU. Light comes on, light goes off. Wax on, wax off, and it doesn't start. So, there is one more conceivable thing I could try, which is a different CPU that I haven't tried yet, but I have to take that out of another laptop, so I'll be back in a bit. So here's a T2250 out of essentially a parts unit, also a 533 front side bus. So let's see how this one works, just for the hell of it. This also was a no-go, so Gateway TA1, also known as the CX2620, also known as the M285E, I believe. Apparently it came with some different capacity motherboards, and the one in this one is strictly limited to Pentium M's. So, there you have it.